Hi guys, welcome back. We're doing Math 172, final exam review. We're going to be going from polar to rectangular or from rectangular to polar coordinates. So there is a set of ideas that you should keep in your mind whenever you're doing this kind of thing. And it's that x squared plus y squared is r squared, and x is r cos theta, y is r sine theta, and theta is the inverse tangent of y over x. This is what you should have in your mind. So there are a series of problems about this, and we're just going to work through a smattering of them. So if we're looking at problem 13, in problem 13, we're given r and theta and asked to find x, y. Now, the thing that I say, that I always say, that I'm sure you're going to get tired of me saying, is that the first thing you have to do is draw, because it'll clear up any uncertainties you have about the sign, S-I-G-N sign, whether things are positive or negative, and it'll help you orient yourself to what part of the unit circle you're in. All right, so in A, they give us R and theta, R6, and 2 pi over 3. So the first thing I'm going to draw is theta is 2 pi over 3, so that gets me over here, and r is 6. So I know I'm in the second quadrant, and I should have a negative x and a positive y. So using what we know, x equals r cosine theta, so that's 6 cosine 2 pi by 3, and y is r sine theta, so that's 6 sine 2 pi by 3. And so this gives us x is negative 3, and y is 3 root 3. So r and theta to x and y, we have negative 3, 3 root 3. And that's how it's done. Let's do one more. They gave us in part B, r and theta, they gave us negative 1 and 5 pi by 2. Fascinating. So again, the first thing I'm going to do is draw a picture. So this is 1 pi by 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I've been around the circle a whole time and a quarter. And the radius, instead of being 1, is negative 1. So here's where I am. Yep, I'm on the y-axis, down by one unit. So again, we're going to use our formulas. X equals r cos theta, y equals r sine theta. So that's negative 1 cos 5 pi by 2, negative 1 sine 5 pi by 2. And your calculator gives you 0 and negative 1. So and the graph confirms. So 2, x, and y, we've got 0, negative 1. Not bad. Not bad. So this was going from r theta to x, y. And in problem 14 and 15, they want us to go the other way. Okay, we'll do that next. So in problem 14, we're given here x, y, negative root 2, root 2. So again, the first thing we're going to do is draw a picture. So x is negative square root of 2, and y is positive square root of 2. So we're here. We're in the second quadrant. So r is the square root of x squared plus y squared. So we've got the square root of 2 plus 2, which is just 2. And theta is the inverse tangent of y over x, which is root 2 over negative root 2. So the inverse tangent of negative 1. So be careful here. When you're doing this in your calculator, you're going to get negative pi over 4, right? Because tangent gives you answers in the first and fourth quadrant. But you've got to know, oh, negative pi over 4 is the same as 3 pi over 4. Okay? So you have to be wise here. Be careful. Or 3 pi by 4. So then going to r and theta, the radius is 2 and the angle is 3 pi over 4. So be careful, because remember, your calculator will lie. So that's problem 14. I think that's all we're going to do for this one. Thanks, guys.